My name is Helena Yuu, and I am a cook here at Canoe Restaurant located in downtown Toronto. And this is my chef, Coulson Armstong.
Hey guys, how you doing?
Coulson and I are together this morning to talk to you about cold pressed juice.
Woo!
Yeah, I'm a big believer.
Right? You love it, right?
I do.
So I want to talk to him about this because every time he has one of these in his hand, he's jacked up. And I really want to know what gets him going and why you love cold pressed juice so much.
For me, I got into juicing about a year and a half ago. Honestly, the first like 2 days, I kind of felt different, and then all of a sudden I had this extra energy. I don't drink any coffee or caffeine, and you know, working 14 hours a day, you really have to like dig deep and make sure that you're mentally and physically in shape for the demand of working in a high-end restaurant.
That makes sense. You don't drink any coffee or alcohol or anything. This is your only form of...
I'm going to use the word vice, but I think one of my vices is being really hard on myself and then pushing my body to the limits.
And what do you do outside of work that can help you kind of push yourself?
A lot of things is just making your mind, so reading a lot, also working out, and running about 3 times a week.
Do you run with anyone?
I run with a group called the Food Runners.
Tell me about that.
Food Runners was started by Chuck Ortez, who's the editor-in-chief at Acquired Taste magazine. He brought a group of eight chefs together about 2 summers ago, and we ran 2 times a week. And it was something really special, and we just like got us in the groove that, you know, working in the restaurant industry is really straining and one of the most like hard jobs there is around. So being able to be physically fit and just having a lot more energy through the day really helps me get through a good service.
And being part of a small community like that, like the Nike Food Runners group, kind of gives you a boost in the kitchen as well, no? Just because you have people to feed off of with your energy and push yourself and make smoothies for each other.
Yeah, so it's a good social group as well. Like, you're not at the bar drinking bourbon at 2 a.m. smoking cigarettes. You're waking up early, getting your day started, and you feel accomplished by the time you get to work.
And I feel that cooks, looking at your social media and being on Instagram and seeing how cooks are doing things outside of just drinking and partying, that's a really good example, and I would hope that you want that out of your cooks as well. Right?
For sure. Like, I push the cooks pretty hard and make sure that, you know, like, this is leading by example. When I was a cook, again, I was out every night and sleeping until 10 minutes just before I could get out of bed just to get to my station, you know? So you have the energy, like just to wake up an extra 2 hours early makes all the difference.
Wise words come with age.
I'm not that old yet, okay?
Yeah. Okay, so this is the last question.
Yes.
Would you rather get suffocated by a 100-pound octopus underwater or chug this whole thing right now?
I could check this whole thing right now. Yes.
Woo!
I
chug it. drink. This is ridiculous, but it's okay. I want to. Good.
Cut.
You're cut.